Let's see this question of IIT JEE Advanced 2015. It's a question of simple harmonic motion. A very good question. This involves concept of phase space diagram. The question states two independent harmonic oscillator of same mass oscillating about the origin with angular frequencies omega 1 and omega 2 and total energies E1 and E2 respectively. The variation of their momenta with position are as shown. That graph is actually called the phase space diagram, and some condition is given, and based on all these information we have to pick the correct option, and it is a multiple choice question. So the graph appears to be like an ellipse, but we'll first prove mathematically that it is indeed an ellipse. So momentum of anybody is any particle is p is equal to mass time velocity, and velocity of a simple harmonic oscillator is omega into square root of a square minus x square. A is the amplitude, x is the displacement from the mean position. So I can write it p upon m omega is equal to square root of a square minus x square, squaring both sides, p square by m omega whole square is equal to a square minus x square, rearrangement p square by m omega whole square plus x square is equal to a square. Now divide both sides by a square, so we will get p square by m omega a whole square plus x square by a square is equal to 1, and that is an equation of ellipse. So the phase space diagram is an ellipse. This is a p axis, this is x axis, and the semi major axis length is the equal to amplitude, and the semi minor axis length is equal to the maximum magnitude of momentum, that is a m omega a. So let me compare the two diagrams, given diagram, with this finding. So in the figure 1, what is given? A is the semi-major axis, and that A is equal to the amplitude, and B is the semi-minor axis, which is m omega A. So for this particle, B is mass is same for all, omega is omega 1, and A is A. So if we divide A by B, and A by B is given the equation is equal to n square. So we will get a upon m omega 1 a is equal to n square. So that would mean 1 over m omega 1 is equal to n square, and that is my equation 1. And now for the oscillator 2, a is actually the amplitude. So for the oscillator 2, amplitude is say a2. So amplitude a2 is r, and the semi minor axis length is m omega a, so that is m omega 2 a2, and that is also r. So if we divide that thing, so basically they are equal, so we can say that m omega 2 a2 is equal to a2, and from here omega 2 into m is equal to 1, that is my equation 2. Let me multiply these equations. So m omega 2 multiplied by 1 by m omega 1 will become n square into 1, that is n square. So I got omega 2 by omega 1 is equal to n square, which is option C, option B. So option B is a correct option. And if I talk about the oscillator 1, the oscillator 1 has an energy E1 equal to half m omega 1 square a square. The amplitude of oscillator 1 was small a, so that is equal to half m omega 1 square a square. And similarly, energy of the oscillator 2 is a half m omega 2 square into a2 whole square. Semi major axis length is the amplitude, and the amplitude for the oscillator 2 is r. So this thing is half m omega 2 square into r square. So if we can divide these two, we will get E1 by E2 is equal to omega 1 square a square divide by omega 2 square into r square. And in the question it is given that a by r is equal to n. So what we will get? From the equation from this omega 2 by omega 1 is n square. So I will use that. I can write this omega 1 by omega 2 into again omega 1 by omega 2, and a by r is n, so that will become n square. And omega 2 by omega 1 is n square, so that would mean omega 1 by omega 2 is 1 by n square. So this, let me write it, omega 1 by omega 2, and that is equal to 1 by n square multiplied by n square. So overall this is omega 1 by omega 2. So finally I will get E1 by E2 is equal to omega 1 by omega 2, mean another expression that I will get, E1 by omega 1 is equal to E2 by omega 2, which is my option D. So we've got two options correct, option B and D are the correct options. Thank you.